Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at how to use remote monitoring inside of DaVinci Resolve 18.5. So what is remote monitoring? Remote monitoring is a feature that will allow you to live stream your timeline monitor to a computer or an iPad or an iPhone, stuff like that. And in this video, I'll show you how to set it up and how to get started. So first off, to be able to live stream your timeline monitor, you will need to have the studio license of DaVinci Resolve. However, you do not need to have a studio license to be viewing the live stream you are sending from DaVinci Resolve. So let's just jump into DaVinci Resolve and I'll show you how to set up remote monitoring inside of DaVinci. So inside of DaVinci Resolve, you'll need to go to Workspace and go down and enable remote monitoring. A new menu will pop up and also there will be an icon down in the corner showing you that you have enabled remote monitoring. All you need to do now is to pick your codec resolution and bitrate. Try using H.265 because that is going to give you a higher quality stream than, for instance, H.264. However, on some older computers, you might not be able to run H.265. And in that case, you are simply just going to run the H.264. To view the stream, all you need is a Blackmagic Cloud ID and the app. The app is available for Windows, Mac, and Linux. And you can find them on the Blackmagic homepage and they are totally free. If you want to use your iPhone or iPad, all you need to do is to go into the App Store and just find the app there and that'll work just fine as well. If you have any problems with the quality of the stream, you can go into DaVinci Resolve and change the bitrate to make a more solid stream. To connect to the stream, all you need to do now is to share the code you can find inside of DaVinci Resolve in the pop-up menu. And you can share the code by email or text. And all your viewer need to do is to type in the code and push join. And then you can see them inside of DaVinci Resolve and let them into your live session. And that's basically how you set this up. Also, keep in mind that all you are sending out to your viewer is your timeline monitor and the music, sound effects, and stuff you have in your timeline. Talking about timelines, your edit needs a great soundtrack or sound effects. And in this case, I am using Audio. Audio is an all-in-one, royalty-free music service that provides great music tracks and sound effects for your videos. And right now, Audio are adding something into their already great music library. It is Audio Originals. Audio Originals are original tracks you can only license through Audio, and they are made specific for content creators in mind. And there are a bunch of tracks already there, and new tracks are coming all of the time. And I probably forgot to tell you that Audio's license covers everything from YouTube videos, client videos, and personal projects. So there is no chance of you getting a copyright claim or strike or in actually getting any problems with the legal department when using music. So if you want to know more about Audio and Audio Originals, take a look down in the description below. And if you use my link, I'm pretty sure there should be a discount included as well. So with that out of the way, let's get back to the video. So remote monitoring is not only great for showcasing your edits, it's also great for showing your color grades. Because if you do a change in your color grade, that is going to be reflected in the viewer's monitor instantaneously. And that is a very good way to show different grades or showing how your footage looks without the grade and with the grade. So again, it is a super helpful tool to have in DaVinci Resolve 18.5. And it's also a pretty good tool to do collaboration with people around the world. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.